In the previous lesson, we learned how to interpret chemical formula. In a chemical formula, we have a number in front of the chemical formula, we call that the coefficient. Within a chemical formula, we have different elements, and sometimes the element is described by a subscript. The subscript indicates how many of that element. In this case, the three indicate there are three oxygen. And we also have the parentheses that group a specific type of polyatomic ions, and outside we have a number, and that number indicates how many of the polyatomic ions. So for instance, we have two, that two indicate there are two of NO3. In this lesson, we are going to look at chemical formula and how it is being used in a chemical equation. So again, chemical formula is a shorthand method, is a method that we use to describe the composition, the makeup of a pure substance. For instance, we have this substance made of one carbon and four hydrogen. And the formula for this substance is carbon and hydrogen, which is CH4. In this example, we have 1, 2, 3 carbon dioxide, and each of the substance is made of one carbon and two oxygen. So we have 3 of CO2. Then in this example, we have 2 water. So we have 2, and each water is made of 2 hydrogen and oxygen. So 2H2O. Sometimes the substance can be extremely complicated. For instance, we have glucose that our body uses. And glucose is made of 6 carbon, 12 hydrogen, and 6 oxygen. And lastly, we have substances that are difficult to draw in terms of this molecular structure, but we can express them in terms of chemical formula, like this way. Now, what is a chemical equation? A chemical equation is a symbolic representation of a chemical reaction. So a chemical equation describes the chemical reaction. But what is a chemical reaction? A chemical reaction is a process in which atoms in one or more substances are separated, rearranged, and joined. For example, here we have a combustion of methane. So we have CH4. Notice how we have CH4. This is the same substance. It's going to react in the presence of oxygen. And notice how I have oxygen here. In this chemical reaction process, the atoms in methane and the atom in oxygen are separated, and they recombine to make carbon dioxide. Notice how carbon dioxide looks completely different than methane or oxygen. And also, they produce water, H2O. And notice how it is separated by an arrow. On this side of the arrow, which is the starting materials, we call this reactant. And the reactant will undergo a chemical reaction to produce the product. So reactant, or the starting material, the products, or the end result. In the process, atoms in the reactant, or atoms in the substance of the reactant, are separated, they rearrange, and they join to form one or more new substance that we call the product. So this is a general description of a chemical formula and a chemical equation. If we still confused in terms of what is a chemical formula and a chemical equation describes the process which, in this case, has an arrow that separates the reactant from the product, where the chemical formula describing a specific pure substance.